Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech, Social This Side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we're going to discuss about cassette transformation. So what is cassette transformation and how we can use cassette transformation in real-time scenario? We will understand over here. So let's start with cassette transformation. So this is one of the data flow transformation. It uses memory cache or file cache as configured in cache connection manager and push data from there. And this is very useful transformation while we are going to talk about performance improvement. So cache transformation in SSIS is used to read the data from wide variety of sources such as flat file, Excel sheets or ADO.NET sources and save that data into a memory or in cache file. And extension of cache file should be CAW file. We have a flat file source. So this is our flat file source. As we can see, it has some record and we want to save that record in our memory. And second, we will store that record in cow file. So go to on SSDT to implement the package. So here I gonna add one more package. So right click on this SSIS package, then click on new SSIS package. Then I wanna rename this package with cache. So here we need to use a data flow task. So we can drag and drop this data flow task and then double click on this data flow task. Then it will directly move to data flow panel. Inside this data flow panel, we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. So our source is flat file source. So we can drag and drop this flat file source and then double click on this flat file source. Then so here we need to select our flat file connection manager. As we don't have any connection manager right now, so I wanna add new connection manager. So click on new. So as we can see, flat file connection manager editor window has been opened. So here we can select our file. So we can browse and then go to on flat file and we can select our first file. Click on open. As we can see, column names in the first row, so we are okay with it. It's a delimited file. Then go to on columns. So as we can see, ID, first name, middle name, last name and date of birth. So we are getting the record as we expected. So click on OK. Then we can select this checkbox and go to on columns. So we want all the column, then click on OK. Our source has been done. Now we need to configure our transformation. And our transformation is cache transformation. So go to our other transformation. And here we can see cache transformation. So we can drag and drop this cache transformation. And then we can connect with source. Now double click on this cache transformation. So here it required cache connection manager. Hence we need to click on new. So here as we can see, we have two options. First, use file cache. If we have the file, and we want to use that file, so we can select our use file cache option. Otherwise go to on columns. As we can see, we are getting all the columns, so we don't want to get the data from file. We want to get the data from source, which is our flat file source. So we are getting the data. So here we need to select any one column as index position. So I wanna add ID as the index position with one, then click on OK. Go to on mapping. So we are getting the mapping and click on OK. Now our flat files data will be loaded on this cache transformation. And this cache transformation uses the memory. So our flat file source data will be loaded in our memory. It will not going to load in any file. In our second scenario, we need to use this and load that data in our cache file. So I wanna add one more data flow task. Then double click on this data flow task. Here again, we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. So our source is flat file source. So drag and drop this flat file source, then double click on this flat file source. Here already we have made the flat file connection manager. So I wanna use that one, go to on columns. So we wanna all the column, click on OK. Now we need to configure our transformation. So transformation is cache transformation. So we can drag and drop this cache transformation and then connect with source. Then double click on this cache transformation. Here we need to add one more cache connection manager. And this time we want to use file cache. So here we need to specify the file. We can browse and go to inside this cache transformation, and here we can select our file. So we can set name with employee, and we can say extension. Extension is CAW file. So it will generate a CAW file once we wanna run this package. Click on open, go to on columns. So we want all the column. So again, here we need to set the index position. So I gonna add index position with ID. So one, then click on OK. Go to our mapping. So mapping succeed. Again, click on OK. So this time I gonna run this package and go to our folder. So this is our cache transformation. As we can see, this folder is empty right now. So I gonna run this package. Once I run this package, then we can see five rows has been moved to our cow file. We can stop this package and go to our folder. As we can see, employee CAW file has been generated. So now we can open this file in Notepad. So I wanna open this file in Notepad++. So as we can see, five rows. First is our column names. Then we have our data. So what is the real-time use of cache transformation? So by default, lookup transformation in SSIS is uses OLADB connection manager for lookup reference table. We can use other sources also, like flat file, Excel source, or any another source except OLADB source. But we cannot use that source directly. So we have to use that sources indirectly via cache transformation. So we use cache transformation to save the reference table in cow format, and then perform lookup transformation using the cache connection manager. Like we have two flat files and we want to compare our first file with our second file. Then we can compare between these files by using lookup transformation. So if we want to use cache data in multiple packages, then we can store cache data in cow file, then it can be used in other packages as well. So we will implement this package while we gonna discuss about lookup transformation. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos, and press bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.